Jefferson Middle School Drama, how are you doing? I want to look at the character analysis worksheet today. Before you do any scene, I want you to know who it is you're pretending to be and how you're going to do that. What are you going to do with your voice, with your body, with your face, with all of those things to make it believable that you're who you need to be? So I'll show you how to do this today with my monologue. So this is just me acting by myself. We'll go through each of the questions and I'll show you how to answer each one. The first thing I would say is make sure you answer in complete sentences. Don't forget, capitalize your first letter, put a period at the end of the sentence. Remember, this is first grade stuff. We need to do it. If not, you might lose points. So make sure you're doing what you learned as a first grader. I'm doing a Chef Skinner scene from Ratatouille. What moods and emotions will you convey to the audience? Chef Skinner, this is my answer. Chef Skinner is so paranoid, he's acting in wild, stupid ways. Okay, my first hour came up with that. I might not have used the word stupid, but you get the point, right? He is angry that someone's trying to take his restaurant. He can't control his temper. So what moods and emotions am I looking at? Well, we got paranoid. We've got wild and stupid. We've got angry. And he can't control his what? His temper. You should tell me with words what moods and emotions you're trying to convey. Be concrete. Tell me specifically. Thank you very much. Question two, how will you express those emotions through your body movement? There were lots of pointing fingers in the scene I chose. His movements are manic and wild. He paces because he's nervous. So I'm going to be moving. I'm going to be pointing. Everything is going to be pumped up and fast. Question three, how will you express those emotions through how you speak? What about the pacing and speed of your words? Certain parts of his speech will be delivered quickly when he's at his most excitable. So my speed is going to go up and down, but since he's agitated, I want it pretty much to be quick throughout, right? Right. How will you express those emotions through your interaction with others? List how your character relates to every other character in the scene. Is it a positive or a negative relationship? How will you show that? This is a monologue, so I'm only talking to one other person, and that other person isn't in the scene, because a monologue just means one person script. So Skinner, he trusts his lawyer, who's the person he's talking to, but he's so angry, he does more yelling than talking. Question number five is optional. Are you going to wear any special clothing for your scene? What will it tell us about your character? I'm not going to wear a costume, so there's my answer. Question number six. What about your posture? Will you stand up, sit down? Will you have a straight back? Will you be hunched over? And why? Think about the way you hold your body, because that's so important. What did I put? I'll bend my knees and hunch over because he's an angry character, and I want my body to look as twisted as his mind is. I want him to look small and sneaky. So I'm going to mirror that with my body. I'm going to make myself shorter, and I'm going to make myself, you know, almost kind of like the Hunchback of Notre Dame, to show just how twisted this guy is with my body, the same way he's twisted in his mind. Isn't that symbolic? Question number seven, what kind of voice are you going to use? Why will accents be used? Chef Skinner is French. I love accents, so yes, I will copy that as well. Why? Because it's fun. Now, the last one. Oh, part of it's on one page, part of it's on the next, but we can deal with it. Does your character's age, gender, income or social status make a difference in how they are treated by others? If yes, explain. With drama, it's all about conflict. And a lot of times, people will use these things to pick on one person. Skinner is no different. Skinner is a sous chef, which means he's the assistant chef with power and money from his restaurant. Alfredo Linguini, the guy trying to take the restaurant from him, has no money, no power, and no talent as a chef. So the guy I'm portraying has all the power. The guy he wants to get rid of has none. So what's going to happen? Skinner is going to use all of his advantages to cheat Linguini, the little guy, out of what is rightfully his. So with each scene we do, I want you to go through these questions, answer each one, capitalize, punctuate, check your spelling. That's what the internet is for. Answer in complete sentences, because I always want us to know who we're going to be before we try to be them. But we will always do this character analysis sheet before we do a scene. It's simple, it's straightforward, and it works. That's all I got. Thanks. Bye-bye.